It's better than a ladder.
Nice.
Hey, I'm Ben. I'm a huge fly fisherman. Welcome back to another episode of Huge Fly Fisherman TV. Today we're going to talk about how to set up different dropper rigs. Yep, another trout video. Well, I live in trout country, come on. There are lots of different ways to tie dropper rigs. I'm going to go over three common methods. First, what is a dropper rig? A dropper rig is just when you have multiple flies on your line, more than one. More flies equals more chances to catch a fish, right? Yes, it does. Double or triple nymph rigs are pretty common these days. Tandem streamers.
You can do dry and dropper or double dry.
Some people even like to carry their dropper rigs pre-tie, but that's just because they're not good at tying. If you want to get fast at tying dropper rigs, you need to practice at home, not on the water. Sit on the couch, binge watch my videos, and just tie a whole bunch of dropper rigs. If you're going to fish your dropper rig, be sure to check the regs where you're going to be fishing. Some places limit you to a certain number of hooks. All right, let's go over the techniques. We'll start with the one I use most. That means it's the best. I tie my droppers to the bend of the hook. So you got your tippet coming from your leader. On the end of that is your first fly. That's called the point fly. Then you tie another piece of tippet to that point fly to tie on your dropper fly. So in this method that I use, I'm tying that piece of tippet to the bend of the point fly. Just treat the bend like a big hook eye and tie whatever knot you want to tie. I use an improved clinch usually, but you can do what you want. Everyone does it a little bit differently. This is how I do mine. I hold the tippet between my fingers like this, and then grab it with the hook and then tie my knot. I've seen other people tie the knot loosely, and then slip the hook through the loop and then pull it tight. Doesn't matter how you do it, as long as you get that knot tied on there. Remember, no rules in fly fishing. So that's pretty simple. You got your leader to your point fly, then tie a piece of tippet to the bend of the hook, and then tie your dropper fly onto that.
This setup is good for all of your dropper needs. If you want to know more about this rig, like how far apart to put your flies, check out this video that I made. I'll leave a link in the description.
Okay, let's go to method number two, and that's tying the tippet for your dropper right to the eye of the hook on your point fly. So you'll have your leader and your dropper tippet both tied to the eye of the hook on the point fly. This method always seemed a little weird to me. It crowds the hook eye and I just don't like the way it rides, but plenty of people use it and it definitely does work. See, I'm giving you options here. So this is what it looks like. You got your leader to your point fly and then just another piece of tippet tied into the eye to your dropper fly.
This setup isn't so good for double streamers.
All right, let's do method number three. That's using the tag end of one of your leader knots. Say you've tied a piece of tippet onto the end of your leader with like a double surgeon's or a blood knot or something. You can leave a long tag end to tie a fly onto. I don't know, maybe like that big. This has been around a long time and I always thought it would be really tangly, but I've been using it on my Euro nymphing adventures with James from About Trout, and guess what? It doesn't really tangle. That might be because I'm an amazing caster, but probably not. So this is what it looks like. Leader knot with a tag end with a fly tied onto it, and then another fly down here.
This setup is pretty much just for multiple nymph rigs.
All right, before we wrap it up, let's do today's pro tip. Who's ready for the pro tip? You ready? All right, pro tip time. If you want to tie a multiple streamer rig, you can buy these pre-tied ones right here. They're from some Japanese company. Pretty slick, huh? Dude, you're gonna catch so many fish with this. Super extra pro tip, if you're hiring a guide to go flats fishing, bring one of these rigs. It's gonna save the guide so much time when they don't have to tie it for you, and they're gonna love you for that. So pick a few of these up. Okay, this is the point where I say all the stuff that I say at the end of every video. Thanks for watching another Huge Fly Fisherman video. I'll be back next Monday with another video. Check out hugeflyfisherman.com. A like and subscribe is always cool too, but most importantly, stay huge. It's just a joke, guys. It's a sabiki rig.